Hi guys, Aries, Hardware Bastards International. Asus has made a considerable effort to enter the PSU market and has released some great PSUs so far. Since the small form factor market constantly grows, Asus had to have a strong presence there. The ROG Loki SFX-L line consists of three members with capacities ranging from 750 to 1000 Watt. They are all certified by Cybernetics with platinum efficiency ratings and Lambda A and Lambda A Plus noise ratings, meaning all three models are silent. Today's video is sponsored by SoftwareKeep, Microsoft certified partner who sells only 100% genuine Microsoft software, has a 24/7 human customer service. The reviews on Trustpilot, 4.9 stars out of 5, Windows 11 Pro. $110. Enter promo code HBI20. Apply. You have 20% discount, aka $22. Final price is $88. The official price from Microsoft is $200. You get it for less than half the price. Besides the SFX-L form factor, the Loki unit also features a 12+4 pin PCI Express connector, and it is ATX version 3 compatible. For those who like lighting, it has an RGB illuminated fan with 8 addressable LEDs supporting Aura Sync. To achieve low noise output, ASUS used large heatsinks at the internals, which is the proper and only way to lower noise output, along with high efficiency, of course. Dimensions. SFX-L PSU, so it is super compact with 125mm depth. Single 12-volt rail, which can deliver the unit's full power output, 850W, and the minor rails can go up to 110W combined. On paper at least, since in reality they can go much higher than that. Cables, two EPS connectors on two cables, three PCI Express 6+2 pin on two cables, one PCI Express 12+4 pin, which can deliver up to 600W, six SATA connectors on two cables, and four 4-pin Molex on a single cable. Internal design. This is a quality platform by Great Wall, which has vast experience in building small form factor PSUs. I should remind you that Great Wall makes also the Corsair SF series. The build quality is high and the primary heatsink is large. However, there are no proper heatsinks on the secondary side, since the 12-volt FETs are on the PCB's solder side and the VRMs are installed on a vertical board. The soldering quality is good, but the PCB's finish could be better. On the primary side, a full bridge topology and an LLC resonant converter are used for lower energy losses and increased power handling. On the secondary side, we find a synchronous rectification scheme for the 12-volt rails and a pair of DC-DC converters which generate the minor rails. The design is modern but not cutting edge, since it isn't required to use a cutting edge design for the platinum category. With higher efficiency, though, noise output could be lower because of the decreased thermal loads. The 120mm cooling fan uses a double ball bearing and is by Champion. Protection features. I will give the 12-volt rail a pass because at high temperatures it is close to 130%, but the minor rails have sky-high OCP triggering points, which are not required, especially at 3.3V. Moreover, the overpower protection is set correctly, and the same goes for over temperature protection, so everything is fine here. Performance. Load regulation is within 1% on all significant rails, so it is tight enough. Ripple suppression is good on all rails. Always, load regulation and ripple suppression are the two first things that I will see in a PSU, besides efficiency and noise, of course. And another important thing, transient response, which in this PSU should be better. I expected lower voltage drops, especially at 12 volt. And transient response under the ATX version 3 scenarios, testing scenarios, the PSU successfully passed all ATX version 3 transient response tests, and with a 200% transient load, the drop at 12 volt is controlled. Still, the Corsair SFX L units perform better. Hold up time is long and the power K signal is accurate. Regarding now the PSU timings, the PSU supports alternative low power modes, which is what the ATX version 3 spec requires. Inrush current is high at 115 volt and at normal levels at 230 volt input. Efficiency with normal, light and super light loads. The platform is efficient, especially at light loads. Average efficiency at 5 VSB. This rail is highly efficient, as you can see in the graphs. Vampire power is low at 150 volt, but I want to see below 0.1 watt at 230 volt input. The APFC converter needs some tuning, especially at high voltage, 230 volt. Average noise output. The average noise is not high, but not as low as the official cybernetics rating. Now, two things happened here. I either got a lemon sample, or the specs changed in the newer models. ASUS should examine this and see what is going on there. Of course, I've already informed them, the PSU team, and I'm expecting some feedback. Fan noise and speed maps at 28 to 32 degrees Celsius. The semi-passive mode lasts long enough if you don't push the minor rails. Even if you push them to the limit, noise output doesn't get affected notably. With up to 500 watt loads, noise remains below 30 decibels, a notable fit for an SFX L unit. With more than 620 watt, the 35 decibel mark is passed, and with more than 730 watt, the PSU enters the 40 to 45 decibels zone. Overall performance, the Loki 850 performs well, but the Corsair SF850L has a significant lead there. The ROG Loki SFX L 850 is among the few SFX L units meeting the tough ATX version 3 requirements. The exterior design is nice and the great wall platform is of high quality. The Corsair SFX L units also use a great wall platform, which is different though from the Loki units. I don't have any photos to show you and it is not allowed so far from the Corsair units, but believe me, they use a different platform than the Loki ones. This explains the notable performance difference between them. Besides performance, ASUS also aims at low noise output. Still, I was not impressed since I noticed a significant difference between my review samples results and those posted at Cybernetics. As I have already mentioned, I either got a bad sample or Cybernetics got a very good sample. In either case, I will inform, actually I have only to inform ASUS to check this out. It isn't also easy to offer a 10-year warranty to a high-capacity small form factor PSU featuring a silent operation. Even a slight increase in operational temperatures at the internals can easily affect reliability, especially in tough conditions. So I can understand if Great Wall noticed something and decided that the fan speed profile was too relaxed and they needed to get it more aggressive. Overall, the ROG Loki SFX L 850 offers good performance, which could be further improved if the transient response was better. Inrush current at 115 volt should be lower too. In efficiency, the platform performs well, especially at light and super light loads. On the other hand, the APFC converter needs work for higher readings at both 115 volt and 230 volt input. Lastly, in protection features, the overcurrent protection triggering points on the minor rails are high, especially at 3.3 volt, and this rail doesn't need so high amperage, so much power.
Given the steep price, during this review, I found it online for $326. The Asus ROG Logi SFXL 850 is a tough choice, but you don't have many options in this category featuring ATX version 3 and PCI Express 5 compatibility. The Silverstone SX1000L is more affordable at close to $300, lacking the RGB lighting but offering 150 watt more. If an SFX PSU can meet your needs, you can also look at the Thermaltake Tough Power SFX 850, which currently is at $200, offering good performance while meeting the tough PCI Express 5 transient response test of the ATX version 3 spec. So, another review. If you want to read the full review, since I left many charts out, this is a video. We cannot put so many things in the video. It will be too boring for you. So, you can read the review at hwbusters.com, the full review of this PSU and not only. We also have a Discord server if you want to get in contact with us directly. A Patreon page if you want to support us. Also, I should remind you that I left Tom's Hardware at the start of 2023, and I also resigned from Tech Power Up. So, the only PSU reviews currently will be posted at hwbastards.com. And I'm not going to only do PSU reviews. I'm fully exploiting the Longwin fan testing machine that I bought last year. And I plan to review every cooling fan out there. There is nothing in when it comes to fan reviews, nothing. I mean, in the way that we do it. And I also plan on changing the story in coolers, in cooling solutions. I will give you something innovative there when it comes to evaluating cooling solutions. You will see, stay tuned for more. And of course, CPU, GPU reviews, everything that you expect to find in a proper IT review site. So, support us, give us strength to continue. We need your support to be able to get more samples from all major brands. Until the next video, bye bye.